Hello, family. How are you doing? Thank you so much for joining me today, and I sincerely hope you're all doing great. So today I'm just really, really happy because today is the day that Harry and Meghan's trip to Colombia starts. That is August 15th. And this has actually gotten so much media attention. It's being reported left, right, center. In fact, just worldwide. See all these headlines? Some of these outlets I've never even heard of, but they are talking about Harry and Meghan's Colombian visit. Even BBC saying that Prince Harry and Meghan to begin Colombia visit. RCN Mundo, that is probably from Colombia, also reports on the same. And I'm just going to be honest here. I believe the only disadvantage we'll have is when it comes to the language barrier, because I'm not able to speak Spanish. So, and I'm seeing how majority of the Spanish outlets, in fact, almost all of them actually speak Spanish. But just like People magazine went to Nigeria with Harry and Meghan, Harper's Bazaar is also going with them to Colombia. And we'll be getting a lot of updates from them, which we'll be reporting as soon as they arrive. Also, outlets such as Glazier are also talking about the same, giving detailed updates about Harry and Meghan's visit. The Telegraph also, that is the UK media, are also reporting on this. Honestly, I would love to be as irrelevant as the Sussexes are, because if you're irrelevant and people talk about you like this, as though you're the president and the first lady, then I would love to be this irrelevant, because they are making international headlines. And these are not the only outlets that are reporting on that. There are so many others that I haven't even mentioned. Because if I do, then we'll have to talk about this the whole day. Literally, everyone is talking about this. And this tells you the status quo of Harry and Meghan. They're known worldwide and people just love to see them. People love talking about them. No wonder they get invited to countries, because these countries want to get a taste of the influence that Harry and Meghan have. Because with this visit, they're definitely going to benefit in a huge way, both economically and also it's going to boost the tourism in a huge way. And Harry and Meghan are definitely going to have a good time. I think that is what I'm praying about the most, for them to have a wonderful time in Colombia, just the same way as they did in Nigeria. So the vice president held a press conference where she was talking about Harry and Meghan's visit to Colombia. And during the press conference, she praised Meghan's feminism, activism, and inspiring path. She also spoke about the racism that she, the vice president, has had to deal with in her role. A reporter had asked about it and drew a parallel with the racism that Meghan faced. She also mentioned what an honor it is to receive the Sussexes, and she looks forward to showcasing the beauty of Colombia to Meghan and Princess Diana's son. That is according to a translation offered to us by one of our Colombian squadies. So thank you so much for this information. And let me just give you a quick update about what Harry and Meghan's visit to Colombia will entail. So they will tour the nation's capital, Bogota, as well as the cities of Cartagena and Cali. And Prince Harry and Meghan are truly set for a busy four-day trip. During that time in the country, Harry and Meghan will meet with local students, teachers, and industry leaders who make up the vibrant, expansive heritage of the South American country. Their agenda will focus on key aspects of the actual foundation's priorities and lifelong philanthropic endeavors for the Duke and Duchess, including highlighting the military community and female empowerment. Francia Marquez, who's the vice president of Colombia, gave a brief interview of what's to come on Harry and Meghan's tour. And apart from visiting local schools where Harry and Meghan will host insight sessions and discuss the importance of digital literacy and mental health with today's youth, It's also confirmed that the Duke and Duchess will also get a taste of the arts and true culture of Colombia. They are expected to attend local performances that celebrate Colombian music, theater, and dance in between other official engagements, such as Harry meeting with the Invictus Games team in Colombia. This week's tour will mark Harry and Meghan's first joint trip to the South American country and their third international trip this year, following the earlier visits to Canada for the 1 year to Invictus Games and also to Nigeria in May. Francia Marquez also expressed her excitement earlier this month about the Sussexes' arrival in Colombia, saying, "In these vibrant locations, they will have the exceptional opportunity to engage with leaders, youth, and women who embody the aspirations and voices of Colombians committed to progress." So yeah, I'm pretty sure that everything is well set for Harry and Meghan's visit, and honestly, I can't wait to see them. And stay tuned, as I'll be giving you all the latest updates on this visit. So until next time, have a wonderful and amazing time.